ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైక పాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృత దుఃఖే నమః. ఓం నమో వెంకటేశాయ. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బిస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మి కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ ఎంటైర్ యువర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. వి షల్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత 7th చాప్టర్ వర్స్ నంబర్ 2. శ్రీ భగవానువాచ జ్ఞానం తేహం స విజ్ఞానం ఇదం వక్ష్యామ్యశేషతః యజ్ఞాత్వా నేహ భూయోన్యత్ జ్ఞాతవ్యమవశిష్యతే. ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ చాప్టర్ ఆన్వర్డ్స్ అప్ టు ద 12th చాప్టర్ భగవాన్ కృష్ణ ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు రివీల్ ద సీక్రెట్ and nature of Ishvara. The life becomes incomplete without understanding about the Ishvara. Because life, it has to be endowed with two kinds of complete understanding. This is like a train with the two engines. You know, the first engine, it symbolizes the understanding about ourselves. Without understanding ourselves, the life cannot be began at all. You see, there are so many sadhus and sannyasis, even jnanis. All the time they refer, realize about yourself. Spiritual begins from the self-realization. But it ends with the God realization. Even when you study Bhagavad Gita, after finishing the 6 chapters, you feel complete. So nothing remains more than this. This itself enough, because I can feel myself as the complete person. My perishable body is not me. Fantastic knowledge. And I can also equalize this knowledge with all the individual sharira. In simple words, if you see the essence of 6 chapter, I am imperishable, my body is perishable. I am nitya, body is anitya. I am atma, body is anatma. I can fix with all the individual body, mind and sense complex. Like when I understand myself as the imperishable me, then I can also understand about others. It looks fine. It looks complete knowledge. Nothing to learn more than this, because all the body, mind and sense complex are perishable. So only the indweller of the body, which is experienced by every individual as I, or me, or myself. The self is to be realized, finished, complete. So what else Bhagavan is going to teach? No, my dear, the train should have one more engine. Then alone you can proceed. Whether it is materialistic life or spiritual life, you should have both perception, both understanding. The first understanding must be about self. Then the second understand must be about the Ishvara. So unless until you have the complete knowledge about yourself, if your mind is not established in you with a samadhi state, as we saw in the 6th chapter, completely endowed with the focused, absorbed with the self, then you can study about Ishvara. Studying about Ishvara only possible when you bring and generate bhakti. The bhakti is not an emotion. If you have the bhakti, you can understand the world what it is. The bhakti is a third eye. And bhakti is not a mere imagination. It's not at all imagination. Bhakti is the clear perception through which you can see the reality, what really is. Now he is going to teach about the swarupa, the nature of the God, but we should have a bhakti, a proper attitude, proper bhavana towards the teaching. Otherwise you cannot understand anything. Because you cannot miss yourself while studying six chapters, because it all about yourself. You cannot miss yourself, but the God realization is very, very, very difficult, I tell you. You have to have complete Shraddha and complete Bhakti. Bhakti is not born with. The fear is born with. And all kinds of emotional things are born with. Fear comes automatically. Jealousy comes automatically. Anger comes automatically. Bhakti never comes automatically. You have to bring the bhakti. You have to establish yourself in bhakti. Therefore, Bhagavan Krishna in the beginning itself said, there are two conditions. And among them, Mayi Asakta Manaha. You should fix the proper goal. And we clarified also what is the difference between goal and destination. In simple sentence I can make, you know, watch your thoughts, which will become words and actions. Watch your words and actions, which will become habits. Watch your habits, which will become your character. Watch your character, which will become your destiny. Now, destiny means what? That is prarabdha karma phalam. The result of actions of my past. The clarity. And we are not even depending on the fatalism. Hinduism means Sanatana Dharma is not dogma and it is not endowed with the theory of fatalism. This is wrongly interpreted by the people. Maybe outside of Indian people. Because they have their own perception on our philosophy, our tattvas. But we have to realize properly. So where you accept fatalism, there is no life beyond it. There is no role of free will. We have accepted the role of free will much. And the role of free will also should be supported by the grace of God. You have to be confident, but you should not be overconfident. Therefore, you have to be in the middle. You have to be confident enough to make the effort, and at the same time, you have to surrender yourself to get the grace of the God. For that, you have to realize. Therefore, I said, you know, whether the life is spiritual or materialistic, the train which is equal to the life, it has to be endowed with two engines. Then you cannot miss the success. That is the secret here. The Bhagavan in the beginning itself says that you have to fix the destination. That destination should be me. Oh my God, if I fix the destination, who will take care of my children? Who will take care of my grandchildren? I have to get the admissions for them from the school. So who will take care of every activity, duties belongs to the family? Yes, of course you have to take care of them, but you should realize they are the temporary station between. You get down, you get some nasta, or you get some tiffin, or you get some lunch or dinner. You get back into the coach, means in the train, towards the main destination. If there is no main destination, this whole temporary destination becomes meaningless. Isn't it? Therefore, you have to be very clear about the main destination. That main destination should be me. It means what? So you have to fix me as the main destination. So what about moksha then? Moksha is nothing but Ishvara. Ishvara is nothing but me. So who is in the form of Krishna? Therefore, Mayi Asakta Manaha. In the last words itself we saw, the destination must be clear enough for the person. Then this temporary destination also should be taken care of. So never ever Shastra says that don't pay attention on your family. You have to play your role properly, and you should give 100% to fulfill what are the duties are fixed. That's what dharma is. Now with fixed mind in the proper destination, then you should be endowed with the proper process called steps, or it is the path. That proper path also will be known, will be given as a bhakti marga. And bhakti means the knowledge also must be supported. Without knowledge, there is no bhakti. Without bhakti, there cannot be the knowledge. First of all, we should not be taken carried away by the literal word meaning. The literal meaning of the words, it may confuse you. Bhakti means which has to be supported by knowledge, knowledge of Ishvara, knowledge about Atma. That's what Bhagavan Krishna says. So the spiritual life has to be endowed with two kinds of lifestyle. The lifestyle which is supported by Atma Jnanam and Ishvara Jnanam. That's what here in this verse. In the second verse he teaches. So I will teach you completely without any balance of it. So balance usually we fix with the amount or something, you know, some account. But here he says, without any incompletion. I'll teach thoroughly about Ishvara. What is that? I will give two kinds of knowledge. Jnanam, Vijnanam. Jnanam teham sa Vijnanam. Bhagavan says, idam, now, asheshataha vakshyami. Completely I am going to teach. Completely means what? Samagram, in the last words he used. This two aspects of the God, which is known as jnanam, means sagunam, lower level of Ishvara. Then vijnana means higher level, the nature of Ishvara, known as nirgunam. Sagune Ishvara Swarupam, nirguna Ishvara Swarupam. Now Bhagavan Krishna has given a division, proper division, Ishvara to be understood in twofold ways. As the Saguna Ishvara and as Nirguna Ishvara. Don't get scattered by the words. Saguna means that which is endowed with form. And that which is endowed with Bhedaha, difference. That which endowed with even Dvaita Bhava. It's the preliminary stage. Once you are thorough about it, then you will get the clarity and clarification about Nirguna Swarupam, which is formless, which is endowed with Advaita Bhavana. Therefore, the lower nature of the Ishvara is endowed with the difference. Therefore, we have many gods. We cannot even name in one class how many gods there are. There are innumerable gods. And all gods are valid by the Ishvara Tattvam. Yo yo yam yam tanum bhaktaha shraddhaya chitum icchati tasya tasya chalam shraddham tameva vidadhamyaham. Doesn't matter, people worship whatever the form through which they worship. I bless them through that form alone in order to establish bhakti in their mind. When you make one step towards him, so he will step 100 times more than you. He will come closer. Therefore, your purushartha should help. So when you say Krishna, you have to give the attitude, Krishna. So many stories are there in our Bhagavata, Puranas, in order to say that, so whatever that if you want to catch, you should catch hold the Ishvara. That the concept of Ishvara is the glory of our Sanatana Dharma. So when you study about Ishvara, you should have the grace of Ishvara. You should have some kind of upasana. As we told, you know, there are three kinds of subject matters, topics are dealt with. Ishvara Swarupam, Bhakti and Ishvara Anugraham. Now Ishvara Swarupa to be fixed as the destination. Bhakti has to be fixed as the path, process. Ishvara Anugraha is the fruit of Bhakti and the knowledge of Ishvara. Ishvara Anugraha means the grace of Ishvara. So if you have the grace of Ishvara, you can step in order to realize the Ishvara. He himself will explore one by one. That's not our duty. We have to surrender to him to realize, because he is beyond words. He is the Nirguna Swarupi. If you want to bring in the Saguna, in the form, you have to surrender first to him. Then he will make himself alive in all forms. When God himself gives assurance, so we have to be happy. He himself says, Yajnatva neha bhuyaha anyat nyatavyam avashashyate. By knowing which, there won't be anything to be realized. Your mind will become a settled one with peace. You won't have a kind of doubts hereafter. It's the glory of Ishvara. The knowledge of Ishvara is the main part of our life, and the bhakti which should be there to balance all kinds of emotions. Bhakti means very matured mind and buddhi with the knowledge of Ishvara, with a complete surrendering to him. It's very difficult to achieve. That's what Bhagavan Krishna says in the next sloka. Let us read it. Manushyanam sagasreshu kaschid yatati siddhayen yatatam api siddhanam kaschin mam veti tatvataham. We saw the glory of the individual efforts. Now he says, this knowledge is very rare. It is very difficult to achieve, but it's very easy when you have a proper guru, proper shastra patanam, it becomes easier. But your karma phala should allow to get a person in order to explore about Ishvara, like Arjuna, who was fortunate enough to get Lord himself as the Ishvara. You imagine when Lord comes to explore about himself to you, so you are the great fortune person. So it can happen at any time. Prahlada had Narasimha Murthy as a guru. Even Nachiketa had Lord Yama himself as a guru. Dharmaputra Yudhishthira had Bhishma as a teacher. So when you become qualified, the teacher will come. God himself will come in any form to teach you. Dattatreya had so many forms. Even he considers a cow as also his guru. That devotion brings everything. You know, if you travel throughout the Bharata, India, you can see there are so many temples, places, they are filled with bhakti. You go to Vrindavan, my God, you are, you know, tremendously will feel the vibration of bhakti. The devotion which flows in their mind, in the place, in every bit of our soil, bhakti is filled with. That we have to open our door. So what exactly bhakti is not told here? What exactly surrender? So little bit told long back in the second chapter. Now he is, because when you have the self-knowledge, surrendering becomes a wonder. Now he says here, Manushyanam Sagasreshu, I'm one among the thousands of people. One among the thousands of human beings makes effort to get Siddhi. Siddhi means for moksha. Have you found anywhere in the university, is there any place we are going to teach about God? No institution is available. No university I am talking about. I am not talking about the spiritual organizations. Is there any certificate that, yes, he is the knower of the God, you can pay him, you can give the job to him? No. The system is not there. It cannot be there. If university at all, if at all they are teaching, then after the realization of the God, so what you can get as the work done from him? So he will become moksha purushaha, mukta purushaha. The certificate is not needed. The paper-based certificate is not needed. Therefore, you know, nowhere outside is spoken or it's discussed about the Ishvara. Have you ever seen from the childhood, if anybody comes, have you realized Ishvara? So how much that realization you got about Ishvara? You have to get 100%, my dear. Any relative of yours, have they asked you? They don't consider at all. They feel, you know, money is the life. When you say money is the life, life becomes hell. So mere money is not the life. Mere sharing is not the life. Only relatives is not the life. Only achieving temporary goals are not the life. So life means which has to be filled with bhakti towards a proper destination. Then every temporary destination also becomes meaningful. Otherwise, you know, if you sit in the train, that which doesn't have the proper destination, and if they say that enjoy your temporary stations, we will be wandering, means it's a confused journey. And the journey which doesn't have the destination becomes hell. So if you want to have a successful life and meaningful, even this temporary, this all sharing, living with family, if you fix the main destination properly, everything becomes meaningful. Every activities which are introduced by our Sanatana Dharma will be meaningful. Even when you show the arati, that arati becomes meaningful once you realize. Otherwise, you know, you may say that this is only blind faith. Realization of the God is not the blind faith. Even it is not faith. This is a complete surrendering. The faith doesn't require with the realization of the God. Because God is not depending on your faith. God is nothing but the fact which remains forever, that we have to set ourselves in order to realize the God. We have to fix our life. We have to dedicate our life to realize the God. At the same time, you have to do other activities too with the mind which is committed to the Lord. Yogam Yunjana, that's what he said in the beginning, in the last words. One among the thousands of human beings makes effort. Even among those kind of making effort people. So one among the thousands, he reaches to me. He realizes me. So these words shows the rarity, the difficult task that realization of the God is. It's very subtle. With a limited system, how can you understand the unlimited system? So that you should have bhakti. So when you see the world threatens you. But if you have the bhakti, the same world, it does the magic. It brings all the examples which are going to be utilized in order to make understand Ishvara is nothing but all the examples from the world alone. We have to be confident enough and keep making effort and surrender yourself towards the God. So we have to surrender Krishna, because Krishna is the God who is, you know, in the form of Bhagavatam itself, in the form of Bhagavad Gita itself. So he has all kinds of glory. We will surrender him. Definitely, we will gain that kind of devotion to understand, to realize who is Ishvara. Then every moment of your life will be experienced like a free person, not only that, with complete amrtatvam. This is, every moment is going to be a nectar in our life. Definitely, we will be endowed with this study. We will be also worshipping Lord Krishna. Om Shri Krishna Krishna Krishna. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.